for this.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
Let's create.
Nah, not yet.
I'm ready to create now.
Nah, not yet. Hold on.
No, let's create now.
Like all right, so we up in this thing. It's another episode of the Skeeters Minisodes. It's I, Big Papa Skeeter, and
Neezy, Mama Neezy.
What up, though?
What's up? What's up?
Slow motion, man. How you feeling?
Tired and big, boss. You look big and tired.
Your feet. You got your compression socks on. You look swole.
No, I took them off. Because I had to give my feet a little chance to breathe. I had some compression socks on all day. My little legs started getting tired and tight, so.
Are they helping? Because it looked like it ain't been, after you take the compression socks off, it's like the swelling go down, but.
They ain't helping now. Now my feet just like, yeah, you can keep putting them shits on, but I ain't doing nothing for you.
Yeah.
At first, they was helping me, and I was keeping my feet elevated, and it was going down. But I guess because we're so far at the end of the pregnancy,
yeah,
the compression socks is like, yeah, nah, I can't help you there no more, partner.
How you feeling as we get closer and closer, right? So we've been documenting. I gotta ask every week, right? Because we've been documenting it throughout the entire pregnancy, so to speak. So it's one of those things where, like, the finality of it, like, hey, nah, like. We talk about, when she gets here, she's about to be here.
Yeah, and I'm excited that she's about to be here. I'm ready to hold her. It's just now I'm really to the point where, like, we thought in the first trimester I was narcoleptic. Man, and since I'm off work now, I get my midday naps. And today, I missed my midday nap, so I'm just, like, hanging on by a thread. I have to have those naps.
And this ain't gonna be no long episode either, cause I'm tired, bro. I ain't even gonna hold you up.
Those naps are important. I ain't even beforehand. It was like, yeah, I'm gonna take a nap, but now, nah, man. Those naps are important because it's really at the end. You know, the baby's so big, and she's moving down. She's in the downward position, so at any time she can pop it and make my water break.
Pop it.
But I have to get my rest. I know I have to get my rest, especially when she gets here, too. But I know I need it before she gets here also.
Yeah. So I know you had a checklist of things that you was getting taken off before the baby get here. So how you had your virtual baby shower?
Yep.
How'd that go?
That was so fun. It was
cool with it.
Yeah, it was very different. But we actually still got to play the games like how you would. So that was fun there. It was nice seeing everybody on the screen. And, you know, we even had to put Hennessy up on the screen because she had to say hello.
She wanted to feel the love, too.
She always wants to feel the love. So, but that was good. And then after the baby shower, of course, we got to do our pictures.
Yeah. Shout out to Stevie D. Vision Life Studios. Y'all make sure, you know what I'm saying, if you're trying to get shot up. You know what I'm saying? If you're trying to get your flicks off, make sure you book you some time at Stevie D. Was it Stevie D Photos or StevieDphotography.com? And then also just go to VisionLightStudios.com. You know what I'm saying?
Make sure you do that.
He did the thing. He had us in there look like $1 million.
He sure did. And that was really fun. And so that was part of the checklist, too.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we only got one thing that's left on the checklist.
Well, that's your checklist.
Yes, on my personal checklist is just I just want to get my hair braided.
Why you can't just wear the poof like that?
I mean, if she comes, I'm gonna wear the poof regardless right now, but I would really like to have my hair braided.
Why,
because
for pictures? Tell the truth. Hospital pictures. Black folks, that the only too. Folks. Baby about to come. Are you worried about, is my hair done?
That too, but still, like, out of convenience, because what I can do is, if I have braids, all I have to do is just spray that Naturally Named moisturizer and oil in it, put it in a ponytail or a bun, and be good to go, and I can take care of my baby.
That poof look like it's convenient, like, right now.
Yeah, but the poof be tight sometimes, and, you know, it be pulling, and so that way...
The braids gonna be tight.
You have to detangle the poof and keep doing that. If I just can put the braids up, that's different. Yeah. Braids is just a quick shake and go.
Yeah, well, I guess. The main thing is that the baby gonna be here, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, as we go, so we kind of checking off our list, too, of, like, what are we gonna do as far as parenthood and like, how we gonna go about stuff. Because, you know, everybody, are you ready? You ready? You think y'all gonna be ready? It's like, nigga, at this point, like, if niggas ain't ready, I don't know what to tell you.
Right.
So I wanted to ask you, because on this show, we've mentioned, you know what I'm saying, like, self-esteem. We mentioned, like, accountability and stuff, just like some of the parental things that we're gonna try to implement. What's a thing for you that you was gonna try to that you will, like, try to implement, you know what I'm saying, as a parent?
Definitely for the baby, family time, mm-hmm. and reading, you know, definitely reading to her, praying during our scriptures, things like that. It's so much, though, that I want to incorporate in there. Well, that we're going to incorporate in it, because you know how I get on my little strict schedules.
Yeah.
Like, we have to, and I hold myself accountable to it, because I really, really get dedicated to it, and it's on my list.
Yeah. You know, I'm more focused on the providing and...
Well, that comes.
And the protecting, because, you know, this is a crazy world.
You know, that's automatic, though. That's automatic.
Not for some. Not everybody, it ain't automatic, man. You see how these people, they don't be holding their kids' hands in the streets. They don't be, like, they let their kids walk like 10 miles behind them on the surface drive.
That's a pet peeve of mine.
Yeah.
Like, that's really a pet peeve of mine. Because just to me, like you said, the world that we live in is so much that's going on. Why would you not hold your kid's hand? Why would you not have your kids?
You don't
in
understand.
Your sight?
Wait till you have kids. You're gonna understand. They get on your nerves sometimes.
Okay, but you always, especially the way that we see how folks be snatching up these kids, you want to keep your kid right in your direct eyesight. So
you can't watch them at all times. I'm being devil's advocate for y'all out there. This is sarcasm.
See. But it's like,
some people think I really be meaning that.
Letting your kid walk behind you, you don't know what's going on behind you. What if it's a dog running up? What if it's a person running up? What if it's a car? You don't know what's going on behind you.
Remember that story I told you when my mom kidnapped me?
Yes.
And
she just snatched you in the van.
And I say that because I was walking behind, like, my friends and stuff, right? And she just, like, snatched. She picked me. It's like a lion almost picking, like, a gazelle out the back of the pack, like the slow, weak one, and just snatched me up. So you thinking, oh, they behind me, they behind me. You turn around and look, and then it's like, oh, shit, they done stole your kid.
Exactly. And... So, and what we were saying, we just seen this happen, like, not even like 5-10 minutes ago. These people, they all leaving the pool and the baby is all behind. What if the baby would have turned around and ran back to the water? You know what I mean? You wouldn't have even, you don't have enough time to react by the time you'd be like, you realize it. So keep your kids in front of you. And I know some of y'all be like, oh, I hate the little backpack leash because it's like a dog.
Nah, we ain't getting no backpack leash. I'm gonna stop you right there. Nah.
But if it's gonna help
ain't no
you,
buts.
If it's gonna help
woman,
you
I said
watch
no.
your kids,
woman, I said no. We ain't about to put our child in servitude.
I say get it if it'll help you.
We ain't
help
about
a parent.
That's not no.
Watch their kids.
No, get your ass in shape and be able to chase your kids around the mall or teach them home training to where they know, like. Because I don't know about y'all, but when we used to go to the grocery store, you just had to have your hands on the cart and you couldn't touch nothing.
Exactly.
That was it. Ain't no running around, except for Tia. Tia used to run around. Shout out to my cousin. Like, she used to run around and do bad shit. Like, she was a shoplifter as a child.
Oh, no.
She was. She tried to get me to shoplift with her, too. She was like, hey, Lauren, put this in your jacket. And I was like, what? I didn't say I did it, though.
Y'all wild.
She was wild. I was the good kid.
Mm-hmm.
Mad City.
Yeah. But I mean, other than that, my main thing is I am really, really, ready for baby London. I'm just so excited. Like, I try to keep myself calm during the day and like every day, but I'm like so excited. I talk to her and I just be like, come on, baby London, if you're ready, you can go in and pop it. And then she'll push down at the bottom. Then she'd be like, no, mommy, not yet. Like, she'll just start wiggling all around. You'd be like, no, come on. I just want to hold you.
I can't.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E.
Can't wait for her to get here so I can stop having to like go get these fucking milkshakes, bro. I on the way home today, you text me. Now I don't have no problem doing stuff for you. It's just this particular task is just annoying as fuck. So fucking Sonic, man. Yesterday you was like, babe, I want a milkshake. I want a milkshake. I stop on the way home. Now mind you, it's not a lot of Sonics to be zigzagging around the city, and you know how I am. I'm efficient. I'm not doing all that driving out the way just to go. Like, nah, I catch one on the way. So the one that's right off the freeway, you just hop off the freeway, whip through the drive-thru, hop back on, right? I pull up in there yesterday, ain't no line. I'm like, oh, I'll make it home in no time. Pull up. Hi, welcome to Sonic. Can I help you? Let me get the strawberry cheesequake milkshake or whatever? Mm-hmm. We ain't making no ice cream right now while our ice cream machine is cleaning. Can I help you? Skirt off. Ain't even no need of me talking to you, bro. Keep it moving. All right. That was yesterday. All right, today, you was like, babe, I want a Sonic milkshake. And I'm like, here we go again. All right, and I don't know. Maybe I just felt it in my spirit, like, all right, it's about to be some fuck shit. But hey, my wife, the baby, they want a milkshake. I got to get them a milkshake. Pull up again today. It's two cars parked. You know how all these restaurants now, these fast food places be trying to be like, they smart park you or whatever?
Yeah.
Where they try to have you pull up to like, advance the line or
exactly.
Whatever. Wasn't nobody there. It was two cars that was up there like waiting, and then I pulled up to the drive-thru. No response. Nothing.
Just two cars. He was just sitting there?
Just sitting there. So I waited patiently because, you know, all throughout this pregnancy, I've learned patience.
You ain't even do the hello. Did you even do the little hello in the little
No, it's not, that's not my job to do that. When you are working at a drive-thru, you know when you have a car.
Yeah, because it pings in your ear on your little headset.
I don't know. They should know. Anyway, so the other two cars pull off. Y'all ain't got shit else to do. Where y'all at? All right, waiting. Somebody in the little drive-through window, and for some reason, this is how you know it's janky, because they don't even take orders out their window no more. They make you pull up. I don't even know why they got the window there. Somebody is looking at me through the window, walks away, comes back, looks at me again. I'm like, you can't even be like, hey, yo, bruh, like, go to the drive-thru. Ain't nobody say nothing. So I waited some more, patiently. After about 10 minutes.
Well, you had some good patience.
My wife wanted a milkshake. I want you to understand this so that you don't be, when I be like, babe, leave me alone about this and that. I tried, okay? I waited patiently for 10 minutes, and I just pulled off. And some teenage kid niggas pulled up and they went and sat down at the little thing. Nigga, this is Sonic. I'm not about to get out the car and sit at the thing.
Sit at their little
table.
Yeah.
Their little weak ass table that they don't clean.
They sure enough don't. They skate out and just
But
be
I'm
like,
just
hey.
Thinking, how trash of a restaurant do you gotta be that you can't even take care of the drive through first? Everybody tell you that's the first thing, like, is the drive through.
Yeah. You're supposed to take care of your drive-thru and your customers.
And it's Sonic. It ain't like you could go in and sit down. It's Sonic. Sonic specializes in the drive-thru.
Yeah, for their little folks to skate out. You want to see them on their little skates.
How many times you seen a nigga with skates on at Sonic?
Probably like twice.
Exactly. That shit,
they actually don't skate out.
That looked cool in the 60s. Guess what? It's 2020, nigga. Just, you can't even answer the drive through. I don't want to see you skate.
Just walk your ass on out here.
But yeah, so that's my bone to pick with them, man. And, you know, we moved out to the burbs now, so I'm back on my bougie shit again, just like how you met me. You know what I'm saying? So certain things are just like, I'm not going to that place anymore. It's ghetto.
I know, because you had a whole little fit with me justified. About going to the dollar store.
I was justified because you wanted to go to that hood ass dollar store because you thought you was getting a deal on it.
I did get a deal.
You ain't get shit. You could have went to CVS and got that same shit. And I know for a fact I went to CVS and walked around and the same shit that you got at the dollar store was up at CVS. I know. I already won the argument. Nope. I've been saving it. I see you brought it up. I left it alone. Okay. I was justified in that. Okay. And I was one of those. It wasn't even on the way where we had to go. You had us go 30 minutes out the way to go into
it. It wasn't no 30 minutes. Don't over exaggerate.
To get a
like
half
that.
A pint of Clorosol or whatever cleaning fuck off products that you had. And I'm like, bruh.
Don't even act like that.
I don't need a big one.
I just needed the mini one.
I just needed
and the dollar store sells the mini
one. Dollar
ones.
Store. Shut up.
They did. It was only at the dollar store.
Yeah, well, next time you could dry yourself. Pregnant or not, nigga.
Had just such a fit, y'all. Like, it was such a big fit.
Because
about
it was annoying. Because in your mind, you didn't pay attention in econ class, in economics, when you talk about opportunity cost. Okay? When you be like, oh, I'm going to go over here because it's a deal, this and that. The amount of gas, let's say it's a $2 or $3 difference in going to this store versus the store on the other side of town over there. Guess what? Okay, you just spent that in gas. So you didn't save money.
But we didn't go out the way. We had to go that way.
We didn't.
We did.
We didn't. I know. Did, okay, so here we go. Okay, nice. You want to go there. According to my maps, if we would have went our standard way where we take the freeway to our main exit, it would have took us approximately 15 minutes. Okay? 15 minutes. Okay? Going that way that you went took us approximately 21 minutes. Okay? The difference is 16.2 miles versus 19.1 miles.
I love you.
Okay? So don't, I don't want to hear none of that, okay?
I love you, though.
And I ain't even about to factor in the gas prices and the fact that, you know what I'm saying? You talk about $2.63 a gallon of regular unleaded, you feel me? Like, come on now. And at a certain rate, you go miles per hour, so you looking at approximately. Nah, see, I could break the math down to you. Clearly. I'm like Julius from Everybody Hates Chris.
Clearly, we see.
So when you talk about, oh, you made a big deal out of it, because the math don't add up. The math is off.
You mad?
Yes, you made me mad all over again.
It's okay. I love you.
And I'm sleepy and I'm hungry. And I'm tired.
You just ate nuggets.
That don't count.
You love nuggets.
They all right. Them nuggets. Chick-fil-A nuggets. I love Chick-fil-A, by the way. I'm about to segue into that. But those nuggets are not filling. But I will never go to ghetto-ass Sonic again. I will go. I brought you a strawberry shake from Chick-fil-A. Those strawberries were picked straight from the patch that was gardened by our Lord
Chick-fil-A
and Savior Jesus Christ.
Strawberry shake was good.
Okay. The milkshake was made from milk that came from cows that were raised in a pasture next to where little baby Jesus was born. Okay.
It was a good milkshake.
Yes.
I'm happy. Our tummy is happy.
It is a very fine milkshake and a good day for us. To worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ when we
Baby
go to Chick-fil-A.
Baby London and I are happy.
Baby London love her some Chick-fil-A because she love the Lord and Savior Jesus. Okay? I'm going to start my own restaurant and I'm going to call it Jesus Paces. Okay? I'm going to say Jesus Paces of chicken. Okay? And it'll be savory just like our Savior was. In the name of the Lord.
You sound like the teacher off of South Park. That's how you sound.
Hey, no, Chick-fil-A go hard. And their service is amazing. They the ones that's like, look, we're going to put you in this long-ass line, but we're going to get you your food ASAP. We know you can't pull off and go nowhere, but you can sit here and eat your nuggets in peace, sir, and God will bless you while the line clears up. Have a good day. Have a blessed day, sir.
Yes.
Yeah, that's all I got.
All right, y'all. Oh, let me tell y'all this before we get ready to segue off and I tell y'all the naturally nay. Make sure y'all are following the correct naturally nay.
Because
there's some fake ones out here. It is another
more
person
of them popping up. We're going to hit you with a lawsuit. Our lawyer is going to hit you with an
injunction.
This one
is naturally_nay with two E's, but they have a 3 at the end of theirs.
it's an E instead of the three, or
no, it's two E's and then a three.
Oh, that's ghetto.
So
they eat at Sonic.
it's a lot more naturally nays in this.
I bet we you did got a find twist that one. You don't know who to trust. So many players. We did find one that just like said us. That
they were a natural hair too, but you go on their page, they only got two pictures. So make sure y'all see our logo. Our logo.
The black girl. Our little black with girl the with the braids. Hair.
And so make sure you go to Instagram naturally_nay with two E's.
Two E's.
That's all. We don't have no numbers or nothing. We legit. We legit out here. You can Google us. Get your instant moisture duo. I am still making orders. We are still fulfilling orders. Even when the baby gets here, we will still be taking and fulfilling orders. So you can get your duo now. And go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay and get your instant moisture duo.
And inaudibleruckus.com/shop, midnightclubmerch.com. Shout out to Gross Power Washing and Cleaning, Muse Lux Aesthetics Beauty Studios, Coach Works Unlimited, all that good jazz, man. I know this is a short one. Niggas is tired, man.
So keep an eye out for, y'all just keep an eye out for pictures and everything. Baby London will be here soon. We will keep y'all updated.
Yeah. It's another episode of the Skeeters. Minisodes.